Dedicated to Eastern and Southern Kentucky, this is WYMT Mountain News at 6.
The search for loved ones. The Perry County Coroner's Office is asking for your help finding the family of a man who died after no one has claimed him. WYMT's Connor James talked to a deputy coroner who's made it her goal to find the family and give the man a proper burial. Connor?
Richard Fluke died this week. He was 80 years old. We know he lived at the Hazard Nursing Home and was loved by many there. We're told he could speak multiple languages and had two doctorates and is believed to be a veteran. The coroner's office is now asking for help finding his family. It's become a mission for Deputy Coroner Ashley Combs.
He deserves, if there's any family out there, he deserves to be reunited with them.
Richard Fluke, a man loved by many at the Hazard Nursing Home, died with no family to claim him. Combs has done research during the last couple of days, hoping to find answers.
They were really upset but they couldn't tell me any family either because they said nobody had ever come to visit him.
There have been leads. She's been able to find out he's from Michigan, but still has not had luck finding family.
In these situations, when there is no family whatsoever, me and my coworkers are the only family that they have.
She's now hoping the public can help. Stephen, if anyone has information, you're asked to get in contact with the Perry County Coroner. If no family is found, he will be buried in the county cemetery. If they find out he was honorably discharged from the military, he will be buried at the Veterans Cemetery in Hyden. And Steve, just a couple moments ago, we found out someone messaged me saying they saw our post and they believe he is family. Obviously, we're trying to get that confirmed and trying to find more information on that. Once we do, we'll have more information on our website and, of course, at 11 o'clock. Steve.
All right. Hopefully we might find some answers very quickly. Connor, thank you very much. Well, someone broke into Summit City on Main in Whitesburg last night. The owner tells us someone used a cinder block to break out a glass door. Here is a picture of the damage. The burglar or burglars only took money. It is unclear exactly how much was taken. If you have any idea who might be responsible, you can call Whitesburg Police. It appears environmental issues are behind the federal government's decision to withdraw its approval for building a federal prison in Letcher County. That is expected to be announced on Monday. The Bureau of Prisons released a statement to WYMT today saying, in part, given new information received, additional analysis should be undertaken to determine if there are significant new circumstances or information relevant to environmental concerns on the proposed action. A reexamination requires that the record of decision be withdrawn pending additional environmental analysis. Now, the project was expected to create 300 new jobs. Congressman Hal Rogers says he is not giving up. A farm supply business in Whitley County had a tractor stolen, which will cost several thousand dollars. It will hit the owners hard if they have to replace it. WYMT's Hannah Reynolds talks to owners at Pruitt's Farm Supply.
Pruitt's Farm Supply is a small family-owned business. The store depends on their local farmers to meet ends meet.
Anything to do with farming, we pretty much have it. So, and if you have a good year, you do pretty good. If you have a bad year, then you're hurting.
Dean Pruitt says he has lived on Angel Road since 1979. Pruitt opened the farm supply in 1996, and he says the quiet area has not caused him many issues over the years.
I've had like late feed out for somebody that's going to be late, and I've had that stolen before.
But all that changed on Tuesday. Two of the men were standing on the dock outside of the store and noticed one of their trailers missing.
Started calling a few family members and stuff because we like to borrow each other's stuff because that's what we do. And nobody had it, and that's when I realized that somebody stole it.
Now the hunt is on to find the culprits. Owners fear having to increase security is going to put them in the hole another couple thousand dollars. This is in addition to replacing the trailer, which could total upwards of nearly $4,000.
You don't put money back for replacing stolen stuff, so it's pretty bad, but we'll just have to work through it.
Hoping to find their trailer soon. In Whitley County, WYMT's Hannah Reynolds.
Owners say if anyone has any information to contact the Whitley County Sheriff's Department. More than 5 months later, and the family of a missing Madison County mother is still holding on to hope she will find out what happened to her. Today, volunteers installed tip boxes around Garrett County, the last place Savannah Spurlock was seen. She disappeared in January. Surveillance photos show her leaving downtown Lexington with three men. No one has seen or heard from her since that night. Since day one, he's called it his dream job. Today, John Calipari signed a new contract that could mean he will retire at the University of Kentucky. Sports director Marcus Browning joins us now to break down what this means for the Cats. Marcus.
Yeah, Steve, John Calipari is in Lexington to stay, or it appears that way. Cal and UK reached a hefty new contract worth $86 million. The contract he signed today is a 10-year extension. Calipari will make $8 million in total compensation over the next two seasons, with increases starting in the 2021-22 season. From that point through the 2024-25 season, it grows to $8.5 million, and then the 2025-26 season, the contract jumps to $9 million per year for the final four seasons. The only incentive in Calipari's new contract remains the performance of the Wildcats in the classroom. Mitch Barnhart said in a statement, "One of the truly unique things about Kentucky men's basketball is its legacy of head coaches who have made their own lasting mark on this program. John is a perfect illustration of that." Of course, Calipari's entering his 11th season at Kentucky, and with 305 wins, he trails only the Baron of the Bluegrass, Adolph Rupp, in total wins as the head coach of the Wildcats.
Overall, it's been a pretty beautiful day here in the mountains, dealing with a few of those clouds, but they're really starting to clear out of our area. You'll notice as we take a look at a few of those cameras, Interstate 64 into Moorhead, those thicker clouds at times, but really we're starting to see most of those get on out of our area. Now, as we look over to the Mountain Parkway, you're seeing sunshine over there, a few clouds, but overall it's just been a nice day, a little bit on the cooler side, but overall not too bad. We dealt with a few scattered rain chances as that cold front and low pressure system continue to push out of our area earlier this morning, and it's out of here, and we'll continue to see sunshine as we head into tomorrow. You'll notice pinpoint Doppler. We're dealing maybe with a few showers, a stray one over into parts of Wayne County, West Virginia, but most of the showers are now up into parts of West Virginia. Temperatures upper 60s, lower 70s. Like I said, not too bad out there, but it's really those winds from the northwest, anywhere from about 10 to 15 miles per hour, gusting 20 to 25 miles per hour. That's what's making it feel a little bit on the cooler side out there. Now, as we head really to the next couple of days, good news is if you need to get out and mow that grass, maybe get out and mow it for your dad this weekend. Friday and Saturday looking pretty good, but rain chances return Sunday and into your Monday as well. I'll look at that full forecast coming up in just a few short minutes. Steve.
All right. Thank you, Paige. The audit of a former sheriff's fee account is being referred to the state attorney general's office. The audit says former sheriff Delano Huff did not give receipts for all vehicle inspections in Leslie County in 2017. The audit also says a deputy turned in $400 for inspections done during a furlough period. In addition, it says two car dealers in Perry County paid the deputy a total of $6,300 for inspections, but that money did not make it to the former sheriff's fee account. A medical helicopter made an emergency landing at the industrial park in Pikeville this afternoon. Officials tell us the pilot reported a mechanical or technical issue. The chopper landed safely. The patient inside was taken by ambulance to Pikeville Medical Center nearby. Teachers from all school districts are welcome to visit Treetop Adventure in Laurel County at the Levi Jackson State Park for free. All teachers can climb for free as long as they are accompanied by a paid guest and have one form of ID. Beginners and experienced climbers have five trails to choose from, which include zip lines, bridges, and obstacles. Treetop Adventure workers say they wish to thank every teacher who dedicates many days throughout the year to educate young minds.
It's a great opportunity for teachers, obviously, to be able to come out, and we are able to show our appreciation to them for all the hard work that they do through the school year, and also to get the kids out into the public and out and out about in nature and climbing around.
Teacher Appreciation Days at the park started yesterday. You can visit again tomorrow, as well as June 19th through the 21st. In November, Kentucky voters overwhelmingly supported a ballot measure that would grant guaranteed rights for crime victims. Those votes have now been thrown out, and the proposed amendment is now void. The Kentucky Supreme Court ruled today the ballot question on Marcy's Law was too vague. Advocates for the amendment say it's only the latest setback in a long battle. Hillary Thornton explains where they go from here.
So I broke most of the bones in my body, as well as lost my right leg.
It was several years ago Alex Audi was seriously injured by a drunken boater, now using her story to advocate for Marcy's Law.
It wouldn't help me now, but it would help people who have been in my situation.
Lawmakers working for several years to get that measure passed, achieving that last year, putting it on the ballot for voters to decide. In November, 63% of Kentuckians choosing to adopt the constitutional amendment. However, the state Supreme Court upholding Franklin Circuit Court's ruling that the question put on the ballot was too vague.
It's a long road, and it's sad when you know you have to start over.
The decision explaining that the full text should have been included and that there is a requirement for the full text to be posted at least 90 days before the vote. Marcy's Law aiming to give victims rights. One big thing advocates say is the notice of any court proceedings or an offender's release from custody.
Huge for me to know that I can run into him in the grocery store.
This ruling making the measure void for now.
And both the Marcy's Law for Kentucky group and Senator Westerfield say they hope this is not the end of the road for seeing Marcy's Law here in Kentucky.
The bill's sponsor, Senator Whitney Westerfield, says he hopes the General Assembly will take up the proposal again. Audie and other advocates agreeing.
We do know now that people are behind us. We'll be back.
At the Capitol, Hillary Thornton, WYMT Mountain News.
Also today, the Kentucky Supreme Court ruled Governor Matt Bevin does have the right to reorganize state boards while the legislature is not in session. Attorney General Andy Beshear sued the governor after he overhauled several state education boards in the summer of 2017. The attorney general argued Governor Bevin overstepped his authority. Bevin's attorney said prior governors had made the same moves. Today, the state's high court upheld the lower court's ruling that the governor's actions were legal.
And we're looking at a pretty big cool down as we head into the overnight hours. Good news is the weather for your Friday going to be absolutely beautiful. But what about that Father's Day forecast? I'll look at that full forecast coming up in just a few short minutes.
But first, the Perry County Fair kicked off this afternoon, and there is a unique experience for those who stop by. We'll tell you about these sea lions